Hey everyone, it's Brandon from Virtual DJ, back with another tip of the day. Now in the old days, if you wanted to change the tempo or pitch of tracks while you were in mid-mix, you would have had to have adjusted the pitch sliders of each deck simultaneously and move them in the same precise increments in order to keep the tracks in sync and not drift apart. Well, this was almost impossible for many and really required a lot of skill to make those live transitions and tempo jumps sound smooth. However, Virtual DJ 8's Pitch Lock and Beat Lock features allow even beginner DJs to perform these tempo jump transitions flawlessly. Enabling the Pitch Lock feature in VDJ will lock pitch sliders of all decks to each other at their current positions. Now, moving a pitch slider on any deck while Pitch Lock is enabled will also move the pitch sliders of all other decks in the same percentage. Now, Pitch Lock is not available to trigger in the current default skin as it has been superseded by the newer Beat Lock feature, but it is still available for you to use by either enabling in Options tab in Settings or by creating a custom button. Instead of having to go into Settings to enable and disable Pitch Lock all the time, we recommend that you create a custom button. Now to do this, first show the custom buttons by clicking on the skin layout drop-down box in the application control section of the skin and select Show Some Extra Buttons. Virtual DJ will now show blank custom buttons in each deck that you can configure for triggering whatever feature you wish. Here we want to assign one for the Pitch Lock. So to do this, right-click on one of the buttons and the custom button information box will now show. Click OK and the custom button editor will now open. In the custom button editor, enter Pitch Lock in the line next to Action. Next, at the bottom, give the button a name. Now click on X to close the custom button editor. The VDJ will now reflect this new custom button in action and name. Now, when you click on the Pitch Lock custom button, all pitch sliders will be linked and moving one will move them all. Now the custom button will also illuminate to indicate that Pitch Lock is enabled. To disable, simply click on the custom button again. Virtual DJ also has a feature called Beat Lock, which is similar to the Pitch Lock but has some distinct differences. Now Beat Lock is located in the scratch panel in the center mixer section of the skin. And just like Pitch Lock, you can use Beat Lock to keep a deck always synchronized with the other deck, even if the pitch is changed. However, Beat Lock goes a step further as it also locks the beat counts of a deck to the other one, which is useful during scratching and other platter techniques. This allows you to use either deck's pitch slider to change the tempo, and you can also move the platter, and upon releasing, Virtual DJ will nudge the track to match the beat marker of the track that is playing in the other deck. As you can see, the Pitch Lock and Beat Lock feature in Virtual DJ are perfect tools to help you make those not-so-easy transitions, scratch techniques, and other effects sound smooth and fluid. That'll do it for this tip of the day. We hope you found it helpful. If you have an idea that you would like to see in our next tip of the day, email tipoftheday@virtualdj.com.